Welcome to the second alpha of Battlefield 5. The guys from DICE have been working on a few improvements to Battlefield 5, and they also based it on the feedback that they received on the first alpha. They implemented all of these changes into the second alpha, and that is what we're going to check out today. Most of the weapon statistics have been changed, and this has a very big impact on the gameplay and also on how you should use each weapon. For example, the SMGs will be much more effective in a close range firefight, but much less effective at longer ranges. Assault rifles will be at their best in the medium range engagements, but they will not outperform SMGs in close quarters. Sniper rifles have more bullet drop, so that they require bigger skills to be effective. Machine guns now cause more damage at longer ranges to further compensate for their weight. The Irma SMG and the MP40 were great machine guns for the assault and the medic class respectively. However, they were too effective at medium ranges. In the first alpha, you could score long range kills as long as you were tap firing the SMGs, and that would keep your crosshairs pointed at the enemy. In the second alpha, they reduced the max damage range of these SMGs from 12 to 8 meters. They also decreased the fall of damage from 50 meters to 40. With these changes, your SMGs will no longer cause as much damage as medium range, and it will be very inefficient to try and score kills from very long ranges. To balance this out, SMGs now have a 14.3 minimum damage rating. The great thing is that you will also be able to stay in the fight much longer, because now you will spawn in with one extra magazine, and you will receive another extra magazine when you resupply. The STG-44 now has an increased max damage range from 11 to 20 meters. If you're using this weapon and you spot an enemy with an SMG, then keep your distance, but shoot him from that 20 meter range so that you have the advantage in firepower. In the first alpha, your shots were only effective up to 50 meters, but this has been increased to 60 meters. To balance this out, your maximum damage has been reduced from 27 to 20. Your minimum damage has also been slightly reduced from 17 to 16.7. This will lower the DPS rating of the weapon, but it will now cause consistent damage during a firefight. You will be able to tell exactly how many shots you need to kill an enemy, and you'll be able to tell how many enemies you can kill with one magazine. Speaking of which, you will also spawn in with that extra magazine, and you will get another extra one when they resupply. The Bren gun and the MG34 will receive exactly the same increases as the STG-44 when it comes to max damage rating and damage fall off range. However, machine guns will ultimately cause more damage to compensate for the weight. The Bren gun will have a reduced minimum damage from 17 to 16.7, but it will not have a reduced max damage. The Guerrier 43 has been nerfed slightly. The max damage rating has been reduced from 26.5 to only 15 meters. This gun's minimum damage was also reduced from 36 to 34, but it has now has an increased fall of damage range from 51.5 meters to 60 meters. This means that your weapon will no longer be that powerful in short to medium ranges, but it will be more effective at longer range. And then we have our sniper rifle, the Kar-98K. Unfortunately, it has been nerfed. They added more bullet drop, and this will mean that you will have to increase your skills to compensate for this. The bullet speed of the Kar-98K has been reduced from 700 meters per second to 600 meters per second. On top of this, the weapon is less effective in a long range firefight. They decreased the max damage range from 20 to 8 meters, and they decreased the damage fall off range from 80 meters to 60. And they didn't stop there, they even decreased the minimum damage of the weapon from 60 to only 55. The great thing is that the maximum damage of the Kar-98K went up from 80 to 90. To summarize, the Kar-98K is not as good anymore as it used to be. I do have some great news for the snipers among you. Your handgun, for example the P38, now has an increased magazine amount on spawn from 4 to 8 and 10 when you resupply. However, they did nerf this pistol a little bit so that it does not come as effective as a primary weapon. The damage fall off range has been greatly reduced from 70 meters to 30 meters, and they increased the max damage range from 10 meters to 15 meters. This means that the pistol is now an exclusive short range weapon. They decreased the maximum damage of the P38 from 30 to 25, but they increased the minimum damage from 15 to 16.7. This will reduce the DPS of the P38, but it will make the damage it causes more consistent. With all of this said, the weapon adjustments are not the only changes that were applied to Battlefield 5. This time around, the developers want you to focus on matchmaking, joining squads, and just playing like you will always do. They claim that they have improved the matchmaking system, and they intend to evaluate your learning curves. On top of this, the developers have been assessing the game in a live environment to help them keep the servers stable. If you played in the first alpha test, then you're now automatically invited to the second one. All you have to do is reinstall it from origin and that's it. Let me know in the comments what you think about these weapon changes. Do you like them or do you prefer that they do something else? This was Fog of Gaming. Remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and hopefully I will see you on the battlefield.